think about the generations and to say we want to make it a better place for our children and our children's children so that they know it's a better world for them and think they can make it a better place.
There's a place in your heart, and I know that it is love.
Every child that comes to us starts a long journey. I can picture it in my mind. First, we find them in the streets, dirty, hungry, sick, homeless, destitute. The crippled we bring into the hospital and make them well, help them to walk and help them to live and grow again. Then those pretty faces start smiling and those brown eyes start sparkling. Their laughter and mischief begins. I can see these same little girls and boys crowding in line, bouncing up to the dinner table with their plates piled high with good food. The girls get all dressed up and braid their hair into pigtails. The boys are already kicking the soccer ball. Then comes reading and writing, the studying and learning. I can't tell you how much I love to sit down with these little ones and tell them all about the wonderful love of God. Then to watch them year by year as strong Christian character begins to develop in their lives. Then, before you know it, these same scraggly little kids from the streets are grown up. These children who have grown into fine young men and women, the future of Calcutta, the future of India. They are the ones who will lift this city out of poverty and despair.
One in every 750 children born in India will be born with a cleft lip and or a cleft palate. This is an enormous problem for the child and for the family, as that child will not only have a physical deformity if the cleft lip is involved, but also because of the cleft palate issues, there may be communication issues and hearing issues. These children need a lot of care. They need a lot of surgeries. They need to be managed with a group of caring professionals. And in India, the infrastructure for the poor to be able to be adequately cared for is not there.
But at the Calcutta Mercy Hospital, no needy child is ever turned away. The doctors and the staff here understand the stigma associated with this deformity as well as the financial constraints of the family. So no expense or care is spared when children with this or any other illnesses arrive at the Calcutta Mercy Hospital.
If you want to know why, there's a love that cannot lie. Love is strong, it only cares for joy, forgiving. We cannot feel there are dreams. We stop existing and start living. Then it feels that always love's enough, hope is growing. Make a better world. Make a better world. Heal the world. Make it a better place for you.
If you care enough. part of their mission to provide healthcare to underprivileged people in India, doctors at Calcutta Mercy Hospital examined every child who enrolls in the school. As a result, they have identified children whose sight could be restored.
I examined all the children in the school, all the children who were in the blind school. I examined all of them to find out whether there was any way in which we could help the children.
So I share as this campus is as an oasis for all India. We have total freedom in our campus. We can go and you can work, play, you can do anything as a normal child. I have my two sons and I did them. I did this, you know.
I tell people everywhere I go, I think I'm the happiest person in the world. But you see, I am only one person. Here in Calcutta, there are so many of these desperate children. Let me ask you, do you hear their cry? Do you hear their cry? Do you hear their cry?